Hi, everybody. I'm Nettie Kaye. Welcome back to the studio. This is episode 5 in our beginning oil painting series. So if you've missed the first 4 and you're a beginner, go back and watch episode 1 through 4. Hey, everybody else did. So, and I also did one of this wine bottle subject in very bad Spanish. Okay, so if you want a good laugh, go back and watch Pintemos con Nettie Kaye un botello de vino. You can learn how to speak very bad Spanish too. It'll be awesome. Okay, so now this is going to be easy, I hope, for you. I know it seems a little bit scary because it's transparent glass. Okay, well, here's my palette, my gray palette that I use. It's a disposable palette. Again, and I have titanium white, sap green, transparent orange, phthalo turquoise, alizarin crimson, that's kind of hard to say, and a lemon yellow. This one is made by Lucas, and Lucas paints, this particular brand of Lucas paints dries faster than the other paint, so I got to watch out for that. But it's because it's made out of beeswax or something. Okay, then we have our medium, which is our Neo Magelp. Remember that? Okay, Neo Magelp from Gamblin. And we use that so that our paint strokes will be more transparent, especially in this one. And also, you can make longer strokes, and it makes a nice little shine, okay, at the end. All right. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to dip my brush into the Neo Magelp medium, and then this time I'm going to just use the light because we're on a really dark canvas. All right, the dark canvas is a little bit hard to see. I'm going to get out of the way a little bit so you can see it, and this time I think we'll put the wine bottle a little bit off center on our 20 by 20 canvas just in case we want to add something to it later. You don't want to ever put your stuff right dead center in the canvas. I did that with our Spanish one, just because I was only painting a bottle. Oh well. But don't put your stuff right in the middle and divide everything down the middle because it's just boring. All right, boring. Take it off to the side. Now, I see that this bottle is about the length of my brush, so that gives me a little hint. I'm going to put the midline of the bottle and measure it with my brush a little bit longer. A little longer in this kind of a limey green yellow. Now also I can take the brush and measure the bottle and see that it's roughly about, I'd say 4 inches wide. And so the midline is going to tell me where the sides of the bottle are going to go. So I've got the, I'll say 2 inches here and then 2 inches on this side. If you guys have watched me paint before, you see I'm kind of messy. It doesn't look perfect right off the bat. You just start and you get the paint down and you don't be so picky where you have to have everything perfect right off the bat. You're going to just be sitting here forever and you're never going to get anything done. You can erase things with a rag. You can shape things with a rag. It's awesome. So, okay, enough of that. All right, I'm going to figure out by closing one eye this is what you see artists kind of doing this, you know? Well, the reason they're doing that is they're trying to make what they see into a two-dimensional thing up here. Hope there's no paint on the end of that brush. Okay, so now I'm looking and I'm thinking, okay, how much farther, how far down does the neck go, and then where are the shoulders? Okay, so I'm going to make this line. I'm going to guess. And I'm not going to make the side lines as long as the midline. Why? Well, because the middle of the jar comes out at you and it's going to have to take a little bit of a dip in the middle. So we'll try to get these as close to being even as possible. I could come right up to this jar or to this bottle and go, okay, wait. All right, the bottle goes up to there before it turns. Test it out and go, okay, well, now this is where the little rag comes in handy. And I take down a little bit and go, all right, well, that's about the length of it. There we go. So then I'm going to come underneath and I'm going to shape the bottle by giving it what I, at We Da Vinci Academy, I give a little smile on the bottom. That's pretty easy. Okay. If I wanted to make sure that this kind of felt like a totally transparent bottle, I just go like this, and I don't want to make it a football where it's got points on the end. That'd be dumb. I want to make sure it's round, but it kind of begins going the other direction as soon as it hits the side of the bottle. Now, up here are the shoulders of the bottle, and I'm going to move it around like this. I'm going to make another smile there, and then I'm going to try to round out the edges there and we're back to our cylinder that we made in the last one. Only hopefully neater. That was kind of messy. Okay, so there's where the shoulders meet. Now, I have to decide how far up, better not get paint all over my stuff, how far up is the neck of the bottle from the shoulders? Wow, that's pretty high. It's actually up here. Measure twice, paint once, or five times. Okay, there's the top of where the lip of the bottle is without the cork. And then that's the neck. Okay, so now there's the shoulder. I'm going to go, that's the center. This midline is just how we get it to where you don't have the bottle going like it's had some of what its contents were. Okay, like it's drinking itself. Getting a little silly. Okay. Now, I'm going to come down and I'm going to gradually taper that line now to there. Okay? Did you see that or was my arm in the way? I'm going to do it with my arm down here. Do, 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 do. Out to the shoulder. And down. There we go. So now I've got basically the shape of the bottle. If I was trying to be extremely accurate, I would step back about 8 feet and make sure I'm looking at it right. Because you know what? I'm off to the side. If I were in the middle, I'd be right here and you would be able to see through my silly hair. Okay, so I'm off to the side, which means it's going to be distorted. You be right in front of your stuff, all right? Be right in front of your painting. Don't be painting down like this or up like this or off to the side because it's going to distort things a lot. All right, here we go. Now, basic concept of the bottle. At this stage, I can now take my rag and I can wipe out this center mark. Okay, I don't need that anymore. Wipe that out, and I don't really need that. So I'm going to take that out, and then I have just the bottle. That's good enough. All right. So we have a couple ways of approaching this. One thing is I can get a basic tone. This bottle, if I look at it, because it's a green bottle on a gold background. Now, I don't see it in the same way you do because the camera is over there and I'm over here. So it's going to be slightly different. I'm going to take some sap green and I'm going to add a little bit of this lemon yellow. And I'm going to fill this up a little bit with this middle tone. All right, filling it up with a bit of middle tone. Again, this is the first time I've done this on a really, really dark canvas, so this will be fun for everyone. And I realize I'm just taking out that ellipse. It's just temporary. I'll put it back. I know where it was. And I'm going to now fill the bottle up with the mid-tone. Any object that you have that is three-dimensional, you can paint a middle tone. What do I mean by that? Not dark, not light, somewhere in the middle. Okay, I don't know if you guys can really see this yet. You'll be able to see it shortly. Okay, so now I have the middle tone, and now I can go in and I'm going to put in the dark part of the wine. Now, the wine, because it's got green in the glass outside, is not just red, but it's also got a greenish color to it. So I'm going to put a little bit of sap green and with my red color. And I'll fill that up to where about 3 inches up if it's life size. Again, I'm making a little bit of a smile. Smile, smile. I'm going to take it all the way down because the glass part at the bottom is actually very dark. Wow, is this a dark canvas? Okay, and the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to wipe off my brush a little bit. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit. Now, if I lighten red with white, what color do I get? Well, let's just say, what happens if you take your husband's tidy whities and you throw it in with your favorite red sweater into the wash? You get pink. And so we don't want pink on the top. We want a lighter sense of red. So I'm going to add something else a little bit different. I'm going to add some of the transparent orange this time with a tiny bit of white. And we'll see if that works. It's an experiment. Just try it. Okay. And so with the ellipse, and I'm going to make this a little bit lower ellipse, I'm putting an orange ellipse over the top of the wine. I'm still really uncertain about the color of this canvas, but now a little bit more of that because it's not very, very strong. I think that has it for now. All right. Just a little ellipse. Now, ellipse is a flattened circle. It's a circle in perspective. Now, the side of the glass, here's the fun part. The light is coming from over here to the right and aiming towards the bottle, towards the left, and it hits the bottle in an interesting place. Okay, wherever something extends itself out in line with the light, My mentor, Helen Van Wyk, would say, wherever the apex or the convex is in line with the light, there's where the highlight is. And those are big words. All it means is where it sticks out or goes in, the place that is out farthest is going to collect the light. So I'm going to now go, all right, there's a light right here. There's a light. That's kind of cool. And where does it come out? I'm going to take some of this light yellow. So I'm taking light yellow, I'm adding some white to it. And it's going to go, it's going to hit the bottle here, not on the edge of the bottle because, well, if it's round, it goes back into space, the light isn't going to hit the edge. It's hard to explain. It makes it look more round if it's just slightly inside of the edge of the bottle. I hope that makes sense. And the same thing over here. So it goes in here and it comes out here. Now I'm not going to extend that down into the wine part because, well, not yet, because this is pretty dark yet. So I'm going to have the light come here, come down here. Same thing happens when you're doing an eye, okay? An eye is transparent, a grape is transparent. The light hits here and it comes out there. And it comes out here. All right, good. So I'm going to put a little bit of light there. Now, the light also hits about right there on the top, and it also hits on the lip of the top of the bottle and a little bit below. But we'll get something not quite so bold. Not so bold. And I'm going to also put a tiny bit of a highlight right there and one on the opposite side. Okay, now that's starting to look like glass. Boom! You can do this. You can do this. But you know what else? It's looking like a glass bottle that's floating in space. So why? Well, because it isn't sitting on a table and it doesn't have what's called, kids, a cast shadow. Cast shadow sits things down, okay? That's what it's for. It sits things down. So I'm going to choose something a little bit darker. Well, it's hard to believe you can get anything darker than this canvas, but you can. A little bit of alizarin crimson and phthalo turquoise. All right, here we go. I'm going to put the phthalo, and I'm going to hit this at about 6 o'clock. Oh, I say 6 o'clock even though it's not a shape of a clock. At the very bottom where the apex, where it sticks out the farthest, I'm also going to put that shadow. And I'm going to extend the shadow out, and I'm going to go up here a couple of inches up, and I'm going to extend that shadow out, and I'll make this really, 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 really dark. Okay, really dark. I think what I'll do is I'll lighten the background for you so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, let's do that first. I'm going to extend that shadow out a little ways. Shadows are soft on the edge. They're not hard edge. If you've got a hard edge, you got a hole in the table. Okay, so that means I need to put something in there on the table in order for you to see it. So now I'm going to grab a larger brush. This is a number 20 Bright by Dick Blick. And I'm going to add some of my medium. Okay. And now I think what I'll do is I'm going to go into my transparent orange, one of my very favorite colors. Wonder why. And I'm going to, I'm just seeing the cloth. The cloth is kind of really a Naples yellow with a little bit of transparent orange. I'm going to get some Naples yellow. I'll be right back. Hold on. Okay, this is a Winsor Newton Naples yellow, and I just love this color. I wish they made it in gigantic tubes, but they don't. So here's the Naples yellow down here. And so I'm going to add Naples yellow. It's a very opaque yellow. Most yellows are very transparent, and so it takes lots and lots and lots of layers to get lots of color into it. This is a Naples yellow, is like poof, boom, really, really powerful. So now I'm going to look at where that yellow cloth hits, and I'm going to put that there. Isn't that exciting? Wow, that is really, really powerful. So I'm just kind of going alongside, and now I can reshape the bottle if I've made any boo-boos in the shape of the bottle. I've got this dark mixture underneath the shadow. So now I'm going to put the shadow, put the light going across underneath so it has something to eat. That's an odd term. Something to eat. I have to have something for that dark shadow blend into, or to, if you don't have anything to blend into, it's very hard to blend. There's, you know, that's part of the issue. It's got to have something to eat. That looks like it's just popping out of nowhere. So I better put some on the other side. A little more of the Neo makeup. And one of my previous videos, I mentioned that painting the background after you paint the foreground subject is like putting on your long underwear after you got your snowsuit on. But guess what? That's kind of how we do it. Oil painting is not like watercolor. It's not like, when you do this kind of thing, you paint it all at the same time. And then I'll go back in with a rag and wipe out what I don't want. Oil will stay wet for a long time. Yay. That's why we use it. Otherwise, we'd be acrylic painters. And sometimes I am. Okay, I might just want to fuzz that out in a vignette. That just means it kind of just goes into space. All right. So here's how I'm going to do it now. I'm going to grab a fuzzy wuzzy brush that's been kind of run down or worn down a little bit. And I'm going to now, hopefully it's clean. All right, now I'm going to go in here and I'm going to take small little roundish strokes and blend the shadow into the background. If I hadn't painted the background in, I wouldn't have anything for it to blend into. Okay, here's the fun part. If this is a transparent bottle, something transparent has to happen also in the shadow. So I'm gonna get a paper towel, hold on. Okay, I'm back. I am going to wipe off my brush. And I'm going to decide what color I want to put down in here. I think it's going to be sap green with a little bit of that super bright yellow. And then we're going to go like this. All right, now it's not going to shine through here. So that's the red part. So now it's the green part. And I'm going to that wasn't bright enough. So let me grab just the green or the bright yellow, which is more opaque. And I'm going to put a little bit of a doodad light in there, technical term. Part of what's really cool for this green bottle is that on the side of the bottle, I'm going to use a very dark value. What am I saying? Dark middle light. That's what I'm saying. Okay. Now, here's hoping I get this right. I'm still not very happy with the fat neck on this thing. It doesn't look very ladylike. So I'm going to actually go back in first, hold on, and I'm going to correct the neck of this bottle. Watch out, I'll be right back. I'm gonna fix it. You're gonna have to see the back of my head for just a sec. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna come back in and try to get this, put this thing on a diet. Okay, so here's what I'm saying. The edge of the bottle is very, very dark. And so I'm going to put a little bit of that complementary alizarin crimson. So the side where the light is, it's weird, but it's the darkest part of the glass. So now I'm going to come in, and it's just a small dark, and I'm going to take the dark, and I'm going to now shape the bottle with this dark reddish color. Kind of working? I hope so. Okay. And next to it is going to be more of the actual color, or what we call the local color. Next to that darkness is more of what it really actually is. So now I'm seeing that that is a lime yellow green right here. Actually, the green is closer in here. I'm going to test that out right in the neck. That's pretty light, so I'm going to put that light over here and test that out. Right there. I'm seeing this in various spots, so it's driving me a little crazy. Yeah, I think it's right. So about halfway into the bottle, next to that dark, I'll wipe my brush off. I'm going to now, okay, put a little more Neomagilp. I think it needs to be just slightly darker. And I'm going to take it. I think I got the cart before the horse. I'm going to actually go over this highlight. Don't be scared. And see how that just drags that light all the way down? Awesome. Awesome. This is why I love to do glass, people. It's so much fun. And everybody thinks you're so brilliant. Well, now you know. I really am. Oh, no. Okay, so are you. All right. So, okay, now, for some reason, I'm seeing that darkness on this side of the bottle right there. And it goes to where it's slightly turning right there. And then it doesn't really continue down towards the bottom. So, the next thing is I've got the background of the what's behind the bottle somehow in the middle of the bottle. What in the world is that, and how am I going to do about it? What am I going to do about it? Well, I'm going to use a darker value of what it is. So that's yellow. I'm going to use orange. The background is yellow. I'm going to use orange on my brush and test it out and see if it works. And I'm going to put that orange color inside the bottle, because the background behind it is orange. Now I'm gonna cut that off a little bit, so I have to decide. So here's that little bit of an orangey background right there. If I cut off, let's cut this off for a sec. This is fun. All right, rag time. I'm gonna rag this out down to here. And then do this. Okay, so that means the background now is in a different place. And so now I can take this part of the bottle and move it back into green. There. And move it down to where if it's distorting, the background might be lower or in a different place in the background. It's just one of those strange things. So I'll put a little bit to where I think it is, okay? Where I see it is right there. Okay, we're gonna put the cork in now. It's a good thing I've got some of that Naples color, and so I'm gonna use the Naples color for the cork, and it's kind of skinny, so I'll just turn the brush slightly at an angle, and then I'll have it kind of come out underneath a little bit. That's a really long cork. Woo! Okay, so we're gonna cut that off with our rag. This is why Viva towels are really important. And then I'm going to add some white to it, because the top part of the cork catches light. And so I'm going to just put a little light there. Boom. Like that. And then I'm going to make it a little bit light on one side. It's, again, it's another cylinder. Okay, so we just do another cylinder, just like that. And then around the edge of the ellipse, I'm going to give that a little bit of a red, and then drag it down. Drag it down a little bit. So it's mixing a little bit with that combination that we had before. All right, now I've got a fuzzy brush. I'm going to take, I don't want just these big stripes of tones like this red and the other stuff. I want to soften up the edges. So what I'm doing is I'm kind of marrying one tone with the tone next to it. I'm not mixing them back and forth and turning them into one homogeneous mess. It's not what I'm doing. I'm going like this. I'm going to take the dark tone and I'm making teeth. I'm going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Like that. And then back and forth over here, back and forth. Squiggle, 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 back and forth, and I'm dragging the brush down little by little by little. And wipe off the brush. And then I want to make this edge a little bit softer because it's going back into space. And then I'm going to take, I wonder what would happen if I just took this big wide brush and went like this. And soften the edges. And what I'm doing is I'm just going to lighten that gray background. All right, here we go. Hang in there. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some sap green and, this is odd, some sap green and transparent orange. That's a little bit scary, but it just seems to work on these green bottles for some reason. Okay, now I'm going to drag that back down through that wonderful highlight, and I'm going to go back in with the red or dark green, move it down into here, and then I'm going to put in the green, the orange, and then I'm going to put the highlight again. Ah, a little bit of white mixed in with it, so I'm mixing that in with that. All right, where else do I see that? Up here, goes all the way down here. Okay, now I'm going to wipe off my brush. I'm going to tidy it up a little bit. We'll be back to see the finished product. See you in a minute. Well, through the magic of television, a cup of tea, and an hour later, this painting is now in a much more finished state. I hope you don't mind. I added the background and tweaked a little bit of the reflections here and there. And I'll tell you my secret for that beautiful color in the background. It's phthalo turquoise mixed with alizarin crimson and a little bit of white. I warm it up with a little bit of Naples yellow here and there, but that's the big secret for that beautiful color in the background. I hope you learned something today. If you did and you'd like to learn more, please subscribe and you'll be notified when the next video comes out. And don't forget to go on my Etsy site and take a look at some of my other paintings. Or my website, actually. You can connect up with that. There's a little kind of a link on the top of my Nettie Kaye Studio YouTube channel. If you go there, you can just, and then you're there. And it just gives you all sorts of opportunities to take a look at my work. Thanks so much for watching. I love sharing what I know. And I hope to see you again sometime soon. Bye-bye.